We're going to look at some of the advantages of going from DC to DCC. We're going to look at where it used to be for DC to where it can be in DCC. For an example right now, with N-scale, and you can see on my track voltage here, we're running at 7.8, give or take. Actually, that train right now, we're running on a 9-volt battery. No big deal. This is what you can call really old school. And it just, that's all we're running on. And as you can see, 8.7, give or take. As we moved up in technology, we've gone from the battery to a power pack. It has a lot of advantages on it. You can adjust the speed, more control over your throttle to full speed. You got direction on it. So you can see the advantages of this over just a plain old battery pack. So as we moved along up in technology, we've gone from a DC power pack. We've actually literally replaced it with a little mini power pack that actually can fit inside your locomotive, either a standalone unit like this, or like a lot of the N-scale units, the little boards. Same with the HO stuff. So what it's done is it's allowed us to take simple things like a throttle, radio control throttle, or whatever, and we can assign it to the mini power pack inside the locomotive and actually control each individual locomotive from something like this. Huge step in technology. With DCC, you can run more than one locomotive on a track at a time versus old power pack system or even a battery system. You'd only be able to run, you know, one set of locomotives per district, power district, etc., etc. People had wired that stuff up. A lot of extra work. So that's just a progression in technology. As for starter systems, I recommend the NCE Power Cab. It's a real simple setup. Pretty much everything right here in my hand, it sets you up, you can run in DCC. Now that we have the NCE power cab hooked up, you can see that our track voltage, 13.8, is set by the cab. Our DC voltage is no longer functional. Even if you go to AC, you're not going to get an accurate reading because of the way that the waveform is set on the track. And it's all done in binary type codes to run your individual decoders. But either way, you can program your locomotive in. Select locomotive 8110. Enter. And that should be it right there. We fire it up. And there it goes. So right now, this throttle is working the same as the old power pack we used to use. Now that I have this set up, you can see that I have the locomotive running at speed step 28, which is full speed for this. For my layout, this is pretty fast. Most of my running I do between 45 miles per hour, give or take, or less. Even though we're running 13.7 volts, this locomotive is probably only seeing on the decoder about 6 to 8 volts to maintain that slower speed. As you see here, I'm running at 0.14 amps at 13.8 volts, give or take. That's kind of high for an N-scale locomotive. You prefer to have it anywhere from 12 to even 10. I run my layout at 10 volts. It's more than enough voltage to run the stuff that I need to run at an appropriate scale speed, even after I adjust my decoders for consisting and everything. Another thing you can do is watch your amps change. As I'm slowing the locomotive down, you can see the amps starting to build up at the bottom at 29, 31, let off of it, and the amps drop. You look at your amps as how much it requires to run everything on your layout. It's this system, I believe, is about 3 amps total. So as you can see, it looks like it can run a lot of stuff, but once you start loading them up and everything, you'll see that it can run less and less. Right, but in N-scale, it takes a lot. So let's say I load this up. I have 3 units in consist, that's 1 amp. But most of the newer modern locomotives don't require that amount of power in them and everything. They run 5, even at the lower voltages. Now we'll look at a couple little DCC systems. I'm not going to go in deep on any of them, but this is a basic Atlas Master Commander system. It's a 2-digit system. I had this for a while running on a 2x8 small shelf layout. Great little setup. It's no longer made anymore as far as I know. You could probably pick these up really cheap off of eBay. If you don't want to spend a lot of money, this is a good place to start. It worked well for me. But it pretty much the next step, what I would actually look for nowadays, if you want some starter sets or these MRC Prodigy Express, this is where I moved up from this. I decided I really liked this and used it. And then it didn't really have what I needed, so I ended up going directly to the NCE Pro Cab. At the time, they didn't have the NCE Power Cab, which would have been my next step to try. This system can be found for about anywhere from $130 to $150, give or take. Good system to start out in. Works really well. In fact, it's really popular. You can find on Yahoo. There's some groups about the NCE systems. A lot of people use this. I highly recommend it. For the people with a little bit more advanced layouts and stuff, I prefer this NCE Pro Cab. I got a radio throttle on it. Excellent system. I can't say much about it, other than the fact it's excellent. You know, I've ran on the DigiTrax stuff. I really don't like the DigiTrax stuff as much as people talk about it. In fact, from what I understand, people on the East Coast that were all into DigiTrax are selling their systems and converting to NCE Pro Cab. The other thing nice about the NCE Pro Cab, and the same with NCE Power Cab, is you can get these small miniature throttles, which I prefer, which are really nice. And just a good setup. Either way, this is some of the stuff. I'll talk about stuff later on in other videos and show you on consisting and everything with different systems. But I'm running out of time, so thanks for watching.